So Robert, welcome to Engineer's Kitchen.
Thank you.
You are our specialist for the pharmaceutical industry. So could you give us maybe some insights about the zenon batch module, so hardware independent batch processing?
Okay, I wasn't ready for that question. That's what you want to ask?
Yeah, maybe. If you want another one, no problem.
Well, yeah, I mean, hardware independent, but of course the regulations in pharma are the most important. So, you know, it carries on the high, secure, robust zenon runtime into a process area. So we're not just monitoring a process now or seeing what's in the PLC.
Yeah.
We're actually commanding the process and telling the systems what to do.
Okay. Yeah. So like a cooking recipe?
Like
somewhat. Like a cooking recipe somewhat?
Yeah. You can call it that way. Yeah, you have, it has all the ingredients. It goes through a sequence and then, yeah, we control how it does that and what comes out at the end, ultimately. Okay, so let's make a recipe then.
Great.
Okay, so we click on new master recipe. This is where zenon is already quite unique in the batch control world, because the ISA 88 standard looks at the PFC type of recipe. This is the ISA 88 defines how batch recipes work.
It should work. Yeah.
So this is a process flow chart. So it's very, very graphical, very, very informative, but not all processes need that. So we provided a different type of recipe to do sequencing. So this is kind of a more discrete.
So it's a bit simpler.
Yeah, it's a bit simpler, but also, you know, process flows is for kind of the process area, and maybe the matrix can do more discrete control.
This kind of thing. Yeah.
Okay, so we'll create a PFC recipe. So let's give that a name. And just like baking in the kitchen, you've got a start recipe and the end of recipe. So here we start to get our tools ready and what we're going to do. And here we end up with the end product. Okay.
Yes,
so everything has to go between
these two. Yeah.
So if I insert a phase is links the process control in zenon directly to something logical in the PLC. So we control the parameters, but also when that control happens. Mm-hmm. This is the big difference between batch control. So I will look at, I just filter this out.
It looks very convenient, a lot of filter possibilities, pre-configured stuff from the engineering, I guess.
Yeah, because if you can imagine, a facility can get quite large. So you would have, you know, kind of hundreds, if not, you know, more than 100 phases here, really. So if I go across here to, let's do temperature, it's like we're controlling an oven. So I'm looking at primary reactor number one. So I've got some predefined phases already here. Mm-hmm. So the unit is primary reactor
it's
number
already
one.
Now. Yeah.
And then I'm going to just insert temperature. So you see we get the name there. And when we open that up, we get all the control parameters around that. So there's certain variables that are used to synchronize with the logic of the equipment, and there's certain parameters that we can change in a master recipe time. So you really protect how the control structure works, but we only allow certain recipes to be changed. So you really separate this domain of the automation engineer from the process engineer.
Okay.
So in that, if we look, we can look at the parameters list, and we are then faced with the parameters that we can change. So this is, we can change the set point. Remember, we're looking at temperature here, and we can define a high limit and a low limit. So at the moment, we have nothing in there. So if we double click, we can give this a value. So let's say 22.
Okay, degrees.
And then the high limit, let's put that at 32. And this one at, let's say 10. So we're nice and safe. So we set the control parameters up. So this is all configurable at the runtime. And then what we can do as well, you know, a recipe, when you're designing it, is a master recipe. And then for quality purposes, you release that master recipe. And in production, you execute a control recipe.
So this is a kind of template concept
yes.
in terms of the master recipe and later on.
Exactly.
We make an instance of it and we have to cut.
Because, like, for example, we could be making chocolate. So we have the recipe based on 1,000 kilos of chocolate.
Yeah.
And then, well, today we only want to produce 50 kilos. So then we allow certain recipes to change. So we still want to make the chocolate in the same way, but we want to be able to change certain parameters. So if I double click in the set point again, I can click here to say changeable in control recipe. So then it will be releasable when you execute it. Okay, so that would be it. If we executed that, now we will be controlling the process as a template.
So we have, let's say, we have a complete graphical engineering based on master recipes and easy to maintain and easy to add also during runtime systems. Robert, thanks a lot. This looks very promising for me, a very dedicated feature for the pharmaceutical industry. I want to hand you over a little thank you for today's time investment.
Well, cool. That's great.
Hope to see you soon again in our engineer's kitchen.
Perfect. Thank you very much. Great.
See you. Bye.
Bye-bye.
What a delicious episode of COPA-DATA's Engineer's Kitchen. If you are still hungry, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.